Okay, so as far as the introductions go, you need to talk with the DJ because the DJ is gonna talk to the wedding party and tell them, explain to them how they should walk in and stuff like that. And the reason why you should talk to the DJ is tell the DJ to tell the people when they get in before the first dance is announced. He needs to tell the people to go sit down so that way there's no one on the dance floor during the first dance. So that's one of the most important things is make sure there's no one on the dance floor during the first dance, guys, because you want as much room to move around and just to take different types of B-roll shots. So so during the introductions is where you're gonna have a chance to actually, you can go and tell the people and also the DJ, like, I want you guys to go and you can get in and do your little dance or whatever, and maybe stand until the couple comes in. Everybody cheers them in, and then you guys go sit down so the couple can have their first dance, just them two. Okay, so that way nobody is in the way of the filmmaker and the photographer so they can be able to take the best shots possible, right? So always tell, remember to tell that to the DJ. Okay, so how do I film introductions? So throughout the whole reception, I'm gonna use about one to two cameras. I rarely use three. The only time I use three is most sometimes, sometimes during the toasts or the speeches and stuff like that, and during the first dance. Other than that, it's just two or one camera. And you're gonna see why throughout this whole module. So let's get to it. So camera setup. So I have one camera facing the door as people come in. So I have that wide so I can, capture a wide angle shot. Actually, not a wide angle. I do kind of like medium shot. So facing the door, like kind of medium shot. And then I have another camera that's just facing the opposite way, just facing the dance floor so it can capture people as they go down into the dance floor. And then I have one final camera, which is a mobile camera, which will be on me. And that one, I just like freely move that camera. The other two cameras are mostly standalone cameras because I'm a solo filmmaker. So that's why I set them the way I set them. But you can set them how you want to set them. But they can kind of like alternate around the stage depending on what view looks the best and depending on the venue. Not all the venues will be the same. Okay, all venues will be different. Some venues will be smaller, some will be bigger, some will have like multiple entrances. So you might not know which entrance. Some might be like oval shaped or circle shaped, whatever, table, whatever, round. You get what I'm saying. Okay. So I can't really recommend to you like how to set the cameras. Just set them in a way whereby you're capturing people as they get in, like their full bodies and everything from the entrance. And you're also capturing when they go and stand. So when they go in, so that way you don't miss the dance that they do and you don't miss them coming in. And then you have a mobile camera on you, which is mobile with you on a gimbal or handheld, and you can just be like controlling the action. And the reason why and that camera for me always has an on camera lighting, right? And the on camera lighting I use, you can scroll back up to module number one, which is the equipments. I have all that information there. So the reason why I have a mobile camera is so I can follow the bride and groom soon as they get announced and introduced and they come in. First time as Mrs. and Mr. blah blah blah. As they come in, I usually walk up a little bit towards them and then walk back with them. And I also talk to the photographer and tell them that this is what I'm going to be doing. So that way we can move together and coordinate and know what each other's doing. So that way I'm not in the photographer's way and the photographer is not in my way. So that's how I do it. I like making this handheld so that way I can maneuver. And sometimes I like going around the couple for their entrance, just to, just to make it exciting. And that's how I do it. So you will see examples of this in the behind the scenes, kind of like showing you how I film the, the entrance, the introductions. So the main thing is just know where they're gonna go, and you can direct them, tell them where they're gonna stand, and you will be good. So that way you know where you set your cameras. And also you might tell them, look out, watch out, be on the lookout for my cameras, don't stand in front of them or whatever. But the best thing to do is have them go sit down as soon as they enter, so that way no one's gonna be in your way. Okay, guys. So for more information on this, just check out the intro, check out the behind the scenes, and check out all the notes in this section. So let's move on to the first dance.